church bells, waving, the traditional waving of the white shirts or hankies or flags as the ships go by. An absolutely spectacular area that we're going through. For those of you that are still up and about and around over on the port or left-hand side, you have the couple of islands over there. You have the natural island of St. George. That's one with all the trees on it. Houses the 17th century church of the same name, as well as the Marat Cemetery dating from 1886 and an ancient Benedictine abbey from the 12th century. This secretive island overgrown with dense vegetation and those slender cypress trees that you see could have perhaps served as the inspiration for the painting The Island of the Dead by Swiss painter Bachmann. And then not far from it lies the man-made island by Lady of the Rocks, with the sailor's votive shrine by the same name. Now this island was built by constant heaping up of stone that started in the middle of the 15th century, and on the 22nd of July, 1452, to be more exact, has been an ongoing process to some extent to this day. And the island covers an area of about 3,030 square meters, and this is the Lady of the Rock Island coming up on the port on the left-hand side. According to tradition, the painting of Our Lady in Perath became known in 1452, and the building of the church on the rock is connected in this tradition with one of the Mortschik brothers' recoveries from illness. They kept the painting in their house after they found it one night while out fishing in the middle of the sea. And to show their appreciation for the miraculous recovery, they took the painting to the Church of St. Nicholas, which was the church off to our starboard right-hand side with the bell tower. And it was later decided to build a church on a rock near the island of St. Elias to honor Our Lady and house this painting. Situated on the very reef where the painting was found. And since the word scripio is known to Croatian fishermen and sailors as referring to a sea, reef, or rock, the name Our Lady of Scripio then means Our Lady of the Rocks, a befitting name for a shrine built upon one. So now coming up on the port or left-hand side, you have the Benedictine monastery with the tall cypress trees and the dense vegetation and the cemetery at the last, but more importantly, the Church of Our Lady of the Rock, coming up on the port, or then on the port, the word capital stands out. So a lot of silver also brought over here to the Church of Our Lady of the Rock. So the Nieuw Amsterdam will be sailing around Our Lady of the Rock Island off the port of left-hand side. It'll stay on your port for the left-hand side. And then we'll make our way out of this beautiful area to another narrow channel.
Bells are ringing. We just made the circle. That was pretty nice that they spent the time to do that. now it looks like we're blazing a trail.